Okay, so like I told you that Russia was under the rule of Tsar Nicholas II and he was the monarch of Russia. He did not want a constitution. He did not want a parliament in Russia. He did not recognize any political party and no one in Russia could write against him. Similarly, like there was the monarchy of the French in the French Revolution. Now, 85% of the population in Russia were agriculturalists and I told you they produced grain for themselves and they exported this grain also. Now, St. Petersburg and Moscow were the main industrial areas in Russia. There were small-scale industries, there were large industries and there were the craft workshops as well. Because of the Industrial Revolution, a lot of industries had opened up in Russia as well. There was foreign investment in the industries and most of the industries were privately owned. The government supervised the large factories to ensure that all the workers work for minimum hours and they also get wages. So people in the craft workshops worked for like 15 hours and in the large and the small scale factories they worked for about 10 to 12 hours. All these workers were divided on the basis of skill. So the metal workers were supposed to be the maximum skilled workers. So they considered themselves to be the aristocrats or the high group of workers. And all the women made up 31% of the labor force. They were still paid less than the men. And whenever strikes were organized, they actively took part in the strikes. Now let's understand the situation of the peasants in Russia who constituted 85% of the population. Now the peasants of Russia were different from the peasants of the French Revolution. The peasants of the French Revolution highly respected the nobility and the clergy, although the entire tax burden was on them. But the peasants of Russia were extremely different. Remember, the nobility in Russia was associated with the Tsar. So the peasants did not have any respect for them. The nobility, the clergy, the king owned most of the land in Russia and the peasants demanded that the land of the nobility and the clergy should be given to them. They refused to pay any taxes, they refused to pay rent and they even murdered the landlord. This was the difference between the Russian peasants and the peasants of the French Revolution. So all these incidents of murder, all these peasants' struggle continuously started increasing after 1904 and the peasants have played a very important role in the Russian Revolution. So like I told you, because the Tsar did not recognize any political party, the Social Democratic Party had to work as an illegal organization for a very long time because of the government policies. Although they wrote inspiring articles in the newspapers, they organized strikes, they motivated the peasants and the people over there in Russia, but still they were not recognized by the government. And there was also a social revolutionary organization which was formed in the 1900s. They also worked a lot for the peasants' rights. They also wanted that the land of the nobility should be transferred to the peasants. Now let's move on to a very charismatic and a very important leader. He was Vladimir Lenin. Now Lenin also became like a dictator in Russia, but that comes towards the latter part of your chapter. Now because the peasants had financially different situations, some were rich, some were poor, some were middle class categories, there was a lot of financial differentiation among the peasants and this could not bring about unity of the peasants. So Lenin was of the opinion that these financial differences among the peasants made the socialist movement a little weak. So the Social Democratic Party, which worked for the rights of the peasants, was later divided into two parts. There was the Bolsheviks and there was the Mensheviks. Now the Bolshevik leader was Lenin and he was of the opinion that this socialist struggle or this peasant struggle should be extremely disciplined and this socialism movement should be carried out only in Russia, which was entirely inspired by Karl Marx's ideas. But Mensheviks were of the opinion that this socialism struggle formed by the peasants and the revolutionaries should take place all over Europe and Russia. So the two parts of the same Social Democratic Party differentiated in their opinions and ideologies. So like I told you, the Tsar was not in favor of a constitution, but the revolution of 1904, which led to Bloody Sunday in 1905, had to make him change his demands. Okay, so the Social Democratic Party, along with the peasants and the revolutionaries, they started demanding a constitution in Russia after 1904. Now let's understand what happened in 1904, which led to the revolution of 1905, which is also famous as the Bloody Sunday.